I will speak in English. I'm actually Belgian and I live in the Netherlands, so I'm a very international person. I will definitely answer the question why the servers are in the United States, but I also want to debunk a little bit the perception that, that the Wikimedia movement is an American thing. So I decided in my presentation to give an overview of how we do cultural collaborations, how that is impacted by our server locations or maybe not, but also give, I think, a bit more nuanced picture of how influential really the American field is or not. So I broadened up the topic a little bit, but I hope it's informative for you. Some previous speakers in the previous days have already talked quite a bit about Wikimedia projects. I won't go too deeply into that. Everyone knows Wikipedia, but we also have many sister projects of Wikipedia that are increasingly used by the cultural sector and by partners around the world. Everyone knows the English Wikipedia is the most prominent Wikipedia. I talk about the English language Wikipedia. So it's not just written by Americans, it's also written by English people, by people in countries around the world who speak English. So to start with, the projects themselves are not nationally based, they are international. And all of them are really, really multilingually focused. We have coverage of more than 300 languages in our projects. Basic principles of the Wikimedia projects, it's also already been talked about it before. We are volunteer projects. So it's the volunteers around the world, again, who make the content, sometimes in collaboration with cultural institutions around the world again. It's not me as an employee of the Wikimedia Foundation who decides what gets done there. I support volunteers around the world. I am not as an employee of an American organization by any means, putting any kind of American-focused content on there. It's really the volunteers around the world who do that. Just to repeat, our projects are freely licensed around the world, many languages. And what is also quite important, just like the Internet Archive, we are a civil society initiative. We are funded by donations, by the yearly donations that are being, asked for Wikipedia. Wikimedia Germany also has its own donation system. So we are a non-profit. It's important to know. Also, one of the previous speakers has also said that we have one shared mission, which is really about the sum of all knowledge, bringing together the sum of all knowledge. So not just American perspectives, but the sum of all human knowledge that can be made freely available for others to reuse. Free licenses, in fact. I show you this map also to kind of give a bit of nuance about American dominance. This is a map of 2015. It's not accurate anymore. It's really hard to keep it on accurate because it changes a lot. But this is a map of what in 2015 were our affiliates. So affiliates are chapters like Wikimedia Deutschland, Wikimedia Netherlands, for which I've also worked a while, Wikimedia Belgium, and user groups, which are more loosely organized groups that can be attached to a specific region, but it can also be thematic. So you can have a gender-oriented user group, or you can have a user group for, Esperanto language, etc. And if you look at the United States there, you will see that it only has some small dots, because in fact we do not have an American chapter. We have the Wikimedia Foundation, for which I work, which is based in San Francisco at the moment. And apart from that, we have different city-based chapters or sometimes state-based chapters. There's a bit more than there were in 2015, so the dots are not accurate anymore, but it's really not like that there is one national American force standing there and defining everything that happens. Just to show you the variety of user groups that we have regional ones. Africa is booming at the moment. We have many, many new user groups coming up in Africa, which is really great to see. But also art and feminism is a user group, people who deal with art and women, representation of women in art. Now, the $1 million question. So why are then the servers located in the United States? Historically, it is true that the Wikimedia Foundation, for which I worked, was the first organization that was established for Wikimedia. So Wikipedia was founded by Jimmy Wales, also an American, co-founded. He had a co-founder, Larry Sanger. And a few years after the foundation of Wikipedia and the first sister projects came about, it was seen, it would be good to have an organization supporting this. And this was originally founded in the United States, in Florida to be precise. And that goes back to 2003, 2004. And at that time was also decided, okay, just to be close to the first office, we will have our servers, our own servers, not in the cloud, our own server farm, really our own rooms with servers, close to the office for maintenance. We have staff still at this moment who maintain our own servers. The content of Wikipedia is not in the cloud or of Wikimedia projects. It's not given out to any, you know, cloud service like Amazon. It's really maintained by us. We have physical machines. We do not do cloud stuff. We do it all ourselves. Why is it still in the United States? Because we have such an international community, we get that question quite a lot. I also, as a European, sometimes ask myself, I would prefer to, you know, have the servers in Europe. But I've talked recently, and I'm not a lawyer, but I've talked recently with our legal team about this specific issue. The reason partly is because it's historical. You do not just move a room of servers to another continent. It's not just, you know, moving some machines and then everything works. It's a big operation. It would cost a lot of money. That's a primary reason, but there's also many kind of legal reasons behind that. One important reason is kind of outside the scope of cultural heritage mainly, but it's really about how our projects work. We work with volunteers around the world who sometimes have a high risk of being prosecuted for the kinds of things they write on Wikimedia projects. We have volunteers working from countries that are not as democratic as our own countries. We have really actually concrete people who might really be prosecuted for what they do on Wikimedia projects. So one aspect, important aspect of also controlling our own servers is that we are also then really the owner of the data over it, and we can decide which data we store and which not. And we do not store personal data at all. So if you log into a Wikimedia project, that's an important step. You have to log in, you can create a pseudonym, then there is no tracking at all, no storage at all of your IP address, of the place where you edited from, nothing of that is stored. So if an authority from a non-democratic country comes to our legal offices and asks, can we, you know, get the data behind that user because he or she wrote things we don't like, I'm sorry, we don't have it. So it's really about also privacy, legal protection of our community. And America is still, even in the current political climate, I asked about that, like, you know, Trump, but yet still it has one of the world's best protections for that in terms of, you know, constitutional surroundings. So that's part of, that's the reasons I can give you. Also to nuance a little bit is that of the fact that all the servers are in the US, we have backup servers in Amsterdam. Because there's some support from there, also financial support from that side. And recently there was also a data center in Singapore, but that's just to do caching and to speed up the connections with those regions. I hope this answer satisfies. What I can say is also that if at some point the situation of legal certainty for our community changes, our legal team is watching that very closely. So there is readiness to move to other places if that becomes politically necessary. But so far, things are going well. And yeah, the servers really are just one part of the thing. And the content that is being put on there is coming from our communities, is very diverse. Response to copyright legislation also from different countries. So there's a totally more mixed situation there. So I just want to say some background more in terms of cultural collaborations and partnerships as well. It might be good to know that at this moment we also have a strategy process going on with our communities. It's very interesting how that goes with thousands of people, thinking about, okay, where do we want to be in 2030? And we, until now, came to two pillars, two parts of a strategic direction that we will go. And one of them is we want to be knowledge as a service. We want to offer our projects as a service to the world, as an infrastructure to the world, to whoever also wants to share open knowledge. And another one is knowledge equity. knowledge equity means that we also really want to focus on that kind of knowledge that has been underrepresented so far. So everything that is non-Western, representation of women, representation of the not like standard white male perspective is something that we really want to balance out. And of course, cultural organizations are great partners in that. The consequence of this is, at this moment, many of our affiliates, including the foundation, are starting to think together and community members about, should we change the way that we organize things? So it can totally happen. I'm really looking into a crystal ball that even the Wikimedia Foundation becomes a different kind of organization, that we indeed decide to move the servers for some reason. So we're not set in stone there. So. Don't take my word on it. I'm not making any predictions, but it could totally be that the dynamics of how organizations work and are moving change a bit. Also good to notice, and I did forget to say that, but I think it's really awesome, and I'm really a fan of that. Wikimedia Deutschland here is, in fact, after the Wikimedia Foundation, the biggest chapter, and it's also one of the places where software development happens, so it's definitely not that everything gets developed and the new Wikipedia functionalities get being furthered in the United States, but we also have a very important hub here in Germany that works on software, on Wikidata to be precise, among other things. Now, just to picture a little bit also how cultural collaborations work in this international landscape, with looking at how America plays a role in there, because that's more focusing on the content and not so much on the service itself, but on the type of content that happens. If you look at the kind of projects that happen in terms of cultural collaborations, they're very international again. Recently, in our monthly newsletter, we had projects from Korea, from Serbia, so it's definitely not just the United States who is doing projects. It is true that American organizations have been among the earliest adopters of cultural collaborations with Wikimedia. In fact, Germany has also been a pioneer in the sense that this has been one of the first countries where volunteers have worked together with cultural institutions, have gone to cultural institutions, but the United States have of course also been a forerunner. And recently, for instance, we had a statement together with the Metropolitan Museum of Art about shared goals, and that may look quite American focused, but we really see that this tendency happens around the world as well. I'm going to skip this one. Again, international Wikimedia volunteer activities like Wikilove's monuments mentioned yesterday are actually most strong in non-American countries. Germany is very, very good at this, as you saw yesterday. The Netherlands, where I live, also has a very strong Wikilove's monuments campaign. Other countries are really rising in that area. Africa is rising. We have other campaigns as well, Wikilove's Africa, which fits into this knowledge equity aspect. Editathons were mentioned earlier, happen around the world. The Goethe Institute could be a great host, is already a great host for international editathons. Glenn Montour, I just want to hint at an interesting model that Wikimedia Deutschland itself here with volunteers has developed. That this is something typically happening here, here in Germany. I also want to nudge a little bit that Europe is also maybe the archive of the rest of the world. So we see many projects happening with cultural organizations and volunteers in the Wikimedia world happening around our media repository, Wikimedia Commons, image uploads, and these uploads are sometimes also very important in international connections between communities. This is an early example of a media donation, but there must be a lot of German ones as well, of the Dutch Tropen Museum, which is the tropical literally translated the tropical museum, ethnography museum, who are a regular donator of media files to Wikimedia Commons. And we see that these files are really not relevant to the developed world, but mainly to the regions where the images come from. So they have donated images from collections that refer to the colonial history of the Netherlands to Indonesia, etc. And we see that especially those communities make very grateful use of these collections.